You see, there are people who commit maksiat after maksiat after maksiat to such an extent, they are despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They say, I'm condemned. And shaitan, and he love in these people. I have committed any zina and had repented but still afraid of the torment of the hereafter for my past. Does Allah forgive the sin of zina? As what we mentioned any earlier, all sins are forgiven by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But what is important is that a person any has sincerity in making tawbah to Allah. That when we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we must have regret. And we must promise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are not going back any to the sin any that we have done. And we stop any from committing maksiat. Three conditions. And this is what any we call as taubatan nasuha. And we mentioned last week also, and also any today, about any the conditions any of taubatan nasuha. So whenever any we make taubat to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with taubatan nasuha, three conditions are present, Allah promise that He will, what you call it, forgive all of our sins. So Islam any taught us, do not be despair from the mercy of Allah. And this is also important. You see, there are people who commit maksiat after maksiat after maksiat to such an extent, they are despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They say, I'm condemned. And shaitan, and he love in these people. Shaitan, and he will tell people, for example, when they commit maksiyah after maksiyah after maksiyah, shaitan, and he will come and say, you are condemned already, and what's the point of making prayers? What's the point of coming to class? What's the point of coming to majalis of zikr? You are condemned. You are committing this and committing this and committing this and committing. What shaitan wants, and you come into a state of what? Disappointment. And this is very, very dangerous, because disappointment in the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can lead to kufr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So never ever fell into the trap of shaitan. So if you have any friends of this nature, you have to help him. You have to help. And you have to encourage him. To tell him about the dangers of the trap any of shaitan. Because any people become apostate any at times any because of this. Because remember, disappointment leads to disbelief. And shaitan any is working towards disappointment. He wants you to be disappointed with yourself. So we must always any have good intention to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah will forgive. We commit any maksiat, we return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But of course, any we do not make intention to commit maksiat. We try our best any to maintain. We try our best to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But at times any we fall down. But whenever any we fall down, what is important is we must always remind ourselves any to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is important. Taubah yani is wajib. Asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for repentance, yani it is compulsory upon every Muslim. Because every one of us, any we commit maksiyah and we commit mistakes. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us amongst the tawabin. Among those any who always return to Allah. And Allah loves any tawabin. Allah loves any those any after committing maksiyah, they return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They acknowledge Allah is their Lord. They acknowledge that the only one any that can forgive them is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is important for us any to take note. And we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this majlis insha'Allah as a reason for tawbah. Now may Allah forgive all of us insha'Allah for all the sins and that we have commit. And insha'Allah yani we renew any our intention and for our obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And may Allah yani open up for us any the doors any of goodness and the goodness of akhirah. Amin. Ya Rabbal Alameen.